Everyone has heart. Everyone wants to be a champion. However, not everyone has the heart of a champion. Liberty University softball has built its foundation and its reputation on having the heart of a champion. This requires not only winning games, but winning souls for Christ. On July 17, 2013, Liberty University signed Coach Dot Richardson to be the fifth head coach in school history to continue that goal.
Liberty University is amazing. When my husband and I got the call to be interviewed here to coach, as soon as I stepped on the campus, I just felt the Holy Spirit. And what does that mean? You just feel this is a special, blessed university because of the mission of building champions for Christ. It's beyond winning games. I'm so humbled to have this opportunity to do that. Liberty is really beyond just going after winning an NCAA World Series championship. It's really about building those champions for Christ.
Coach Dot Richardson is one of the most decorated collegiate names in all of sports. Her long list of accomplishments include two Olympic gold medals and the 1980s Player of the Decade. However, her relationship with God exceeds all of these things.
Well, I am a player coach, meaning that my experience in over 30 years of playing the sport of fast pitch softball, I like the coach the way that I wanted to be coached and was coached. There's a lot of different styles out there, of course, but I basically believe in teaching the fundamentals of the game. And in doing that, is the motivation is there within our players to try to master those fundamentals. It builds their mental confidence. But I know without a doubt, a player will never reach her full potential or his full potential unless he recognizes that God has given her or him the talent and the opportunity.
I think mainly Coach Richardson has just taught me so many things about the game. Not only physically, but mentally and strategic-wise. Like, she has just such a mind for softball, and it's been really great to learn from that.
She's so positive. Like, if anyone's been around her and she's talked to them for 30 seconds, you just feel like you can get out and, like, run a marathon or something, or conquer the world. She's just a great inspiration.
The Liberty University softball team has made many upgrades, including its stadium. Since the start of the program in 1979, the Lady Flames have played their games in their home stadium, which only holds 500 people. With the signing of a high-profile coach such as Richardson, Liberty University knew they were going to have to upgrade their facilities.
When I gave everything to the Lord as far as my future, I'll never forget. I said, "Please, Lord, show me how I can serve you more," and make it perfectly clear. The next morning at 9 o'clock, I received a phone call from Jeff Barber, the athletic director here at Liberty University. And he said a couple things. One is the previous coach had retired and they're looking to fill that position with someone who has name recognition and also, "Coach, we want to build a stadium, just best in the nation." And when people say that, you always think, well, maybe 3-5 years down the line, but oh no, not at Liberty. The first week that we were here on a Thursday morning, went in to about 20 construction men and architects, and they basically looked and said, "Well, Coach, what do you want?" Well, behind us, this is what we have wanted. $9 million softball stadium already has impacted the sport in a huge way just by the discussion of the facility we have. When you look at where we are starting with humble beginnings, I've seen a lot of high school softball fields much better than our previous field. Our office is in a double-wide trailer. To now look and see what has developed and what are we're going to be moving into, and the type of and the caliber of athletes that we're getting, I believe that the Lord is something very special that we are going to be doing through Liberty Softball.
It's a whole new atmosphere from the old stadium. We're just so blessed. The first game we went in there, it was just, we all had chill bombs. Like, we couldn't even comprehend the amazing feeling.
I was hurt, so I wasn't able to play in the home tournament, but I could just tell just standing there watching the girls, you know, everyone was so pumped up and ready. It was like, it's not anything I've ever seen our team act like and play like.
The process outweighs the event. The process is what people don't see. The hard work, the long hours, put in to make these athletes great. However, the process has been tough for some players due to things such as injuries. But it's times like these that determine the true heart of a champion.
I tore my ACL almost a year ago now. It was during the OKC, Oklahoma City Challenge. Last event, just quick little sprints, got a little shove from the back and fell, and it was torn, as well as both meniscus. So it was devastating in my mind, but just with the people that I was surrounded by, and being at Liberty University, obviously, I was shocked to see how encouraged I was by the incident overall.
Chandler tore her ACL in a game against Ole Miss in February, first game she ever pitched. She's come back a lot quicker than Kenzie just because she kind of had the foundation to start back on. She didn't really have to relearn how to pitch. So once she was clear, she's kind of just caught right back up.
And it really was just a freak thing. Just one pitch went down, and really didn't think it was anything too serious at first, but it turned out I did tear it. So coming back from that, I really wanted to, no more than 6 months. I was driven. I was going to get this done in 6 months. And I think the rest of that season, while I struggled, I think mentally, just dealing with not getting to play, trying to find new ways to lead and just be there for my team. And I think that's what kept me going over the last 6 months, knowing that there was better things to come.
All those rehabilitation hours and exercises and strengthening, that he would get me back to the point where I could play again. And that is why it was such a big milestone for me to play that fall tournament.
Our first tournament here, September 27th of 2014, she was throwing 63. She has come a full circle as far as pitching, and I've told her I think her getting injured is the best thing that could have happened to her.
On September 27th, 2014, Coach Richardson Flames hosted the Round Robin Tournament. The Flames won 5 out of 7 games with the help of Kenzie and Champion back from the game. While keeping Jesus Christ in the center of everything, the Flames look forward to building on the success going into their upcoming season, as well as the future of the program.
Coach Richardson has gotten us on the map, to say. We're starting to play really big programs. That's been really awesome, but instead of just playing them, I think we're going to see Liberty softball being competitive.
I see Liberty softball as one of the top programs in the country. It's going to be God working through us, because obviously, Jesus said we can't do anything apart from him.
The coaches that we have, our stadium, just what they're doing recruiting-wise, I mean, I don't see why a national championship isn't in our future. I mean, what's to stop us? I mean, that field is amazing. We have every tool at our disposal, so we definitely expect bigger and better things.
I see Liberty softball as World Series champions, national champions in our sport. And I see it as a testimony to give the credit and the glory to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.